CD atypical antidepressant medications. We have bupropion, trazodone, mirtazapine, varenicline, vortioxetine, bolizodone. All right. This antidepressant or atypical antidepressant drug, mainly the use is for major depressive disorder, but with something else. So bupropion, for example, is major depressive disorder, but for example with cessation smoking desire, for example. The only one that is not used for major depressive disorder is varenicline, which main use is for stop smoking. The mechanism of action, it is a partial agonist of the acetylcholine of the nicotinic receptors, and so stimulates the nicotinic effect of the tobacco. The adverse effect is cephalea, irritability, insomnia, and suicidal ideations. These two medications are quite similar. They both are antagonists of the 5-hydroxytryptamine receptors 2 and 3. They inhibit the reuptake of 5-hydroxytryptamine. Actually, only vortioxetine blocks the 5-hydroxytryptamine subtype 2, and this one blocks all this. Here, I will talk of the mechanism of action at the end or the integration. Mirtazapine is a blocker of alpha-2 adrenergic receptors, or antagonist of alpha-2 adrenergic receptors, as well as histamine type 1 and 5-hydroxytryptamine type 2. Trazodone is quite similar, alpha-2 adrenergic receptor antagonist, 5-hydroxytryptamine reuptake inhibitor, and a 5-hydroxytryptamine 2 antagonist, and histamine 1 receptor antagonist. And bupropion is a dopamine norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor. So, the mechanism of action. Here we have a synaptic button that is releasing, for bupropion, dopamine and norepinephrine. Here we have the reuptake, so dopamine and norepinephrine come here, enter, and they at the end go to the vesicles, and then they got released again. If we block this reuptake, we increase the dopamine and the norepinephrine that is here, and so we decrease the pressure. Next, for these ones, we are inhibiting the reuptake of serotonin, 5-hydroxytryptamine. So if we inhibit the reuptake of serotonin, we are increasing the serotonin on this synaptic cleft. Additionally, we are blocking the 5-hydroxytryptamine receptors, but because we are not blocking the 5-hydroxytryptamine subtype 1A receptor, that is the one that is on the central nervous system, we don't see any effect on depression on that matter. So we don't care that we are blocking these receptors, we care that we are increasing the 5-hydroxytryptamine on the synaptic cleft, and so there is more serotonin available for the 5-hydroxytryptamine 1A receptors, even though not for these ones, because we are blocking additionally this effect, even though we are increasing the 5-hydroxytryptamine on the synaptic cleft. Mirtazapine and trazodone have the same effect on blocking the reuptake, and they are blocking also the 5-hydroxytryptamine 2 receptor that we don't care. We just care the effect of serotonin on the 5-hydroxytryptamine 1A receptor. Additionally, they are blocking the alpha-2 adrenergic receptor for norepinephrine. So norepinephrine comes here to this receptor. This is not a reuptake. Functions like a reuptake, but is not a reuptake. Here we have the norepinephrine is coming to the receptor, then activates the G protein that is coupled to the receptor, GI protein. Then this will inhibit the adenylate cyclase, and so there will be less release of norepinephrine in the synaptic cleft. So if we block the alpha-2 adrenergic receptor, we have a lot of norepinephrine on the synaptic cleft. This for both of them, and the adverse effect will be the sedation. So, sedation by the histamine 1A receptors antagonist, and also the postural for trazodone, also postural hypotension and priapism. Mirtazapine also increases weight and dry mouth. Varenicline, we already talked about that. This one both have anticholinergic effect and nausea, both of them. Bortioxetine additionally has sleep disturbance and sexual disturbance. And this one has nausea and insomnia and headache, cephalea. So these two are increased risk of produced serotonin syndrome taking with other drugs. Mirtazapine is used for major depressive disorder when the patient has a lot of insomnia, because we would sedate also the patient, and when the patient has a very poorly appetite, because we are doing weight gain giving mirtazapine. Trazodone, its main use is for insomnia, not for depression, because for depression we need high doses. Bupropion is used for antidepressant medication when we don't want any issue with weight gain nor sedation, or if the patient also wants to try quit of smoke, because helps patients. But the adverse effects are seizures, headache, and sympathetic activity. The concern is with seizures, the threshold is increased, but certainly we cannot use bupropion for bulimia or anorexia nervosa patients.